गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं जैन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति सपदं। उपदेश अमृतम द नेचर ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन बाय श्रील रूप गोस्वामी श्रील भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी महाराज हैज एक्सप्लेन्ड एंड मेड ए टीका और द नेक्टर ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन दैट इज उपदेश अमृतम। These instructions are from neophyte devotees up to the highest top of devotees for all. Especially Srila Rupa Goswami Maharaj was inspired by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at Prayag, and he gave so many instructions, especially of Raganuga Bhajan Sadhan, and he gave outlines of all the topics of bhakti, tops of bhaktis, prema bhaktis, how to enter and how to cultivate it. Krishna came and he tested all kinds of bhakti, rasa, but he could not give the process in which a neophyte devotees, that is Kanishta Adhikari, will come. Kaha gaya? No electricity?
It is on.
What are you doing? Who is in power?
Nirgun Prabhu.
Nirgun will take care of everything, as usual.
Not working?
Yes,
just the red one.
How a Nephite, Prakrit or Kanishta Adhikari will come into Madhyam Adhikari, and Madhyam Adhikari will gracefully come cultivate their bhaktis to Uttam Adhikari. And Uttam Adhikari, how he can come? In Swarup Siddha Bhakti. And a Swarup Siddha Bhakti will come, into Nitya Siddha, Vastu Siddha Bhakta, Premi Bhakta. I have explained Upadeshamrita's four shlokas in London, and I easily tell them. Fifth shlok I am beginning here. We should not give our attention to anything. Whole intention should be given. If you read anything, you should be absorbed in that. I am serving this thing, And I'm taking all these instructions in my heart, not only to hear by this ear and to take out from this. There is a very beautiful story that in India there was a king named Vikramaditya. He has so many nine jewels, court jewels. All nines were so learned. Among them, Kalidas was supreme, intelligent. One day, a person like madman,
crazy person,
having don't do anything.
Having a skull.
A skull.
Yeah.
Narmunda.
Skull.
Skull.
A skull taking in his hand. Quite naked. So much dirty. And he came in the council of Vikramaditya. And he put that skull on the desk and told, I've heard that there are so many intelligent jewels in your court council. Let them come here and they should test whether the person whose skull is this, skull is this, he was intelligent or not intelligent. He was quite full and rascal. 8 jewels were there, very learned person, and whole council was full up. But none was ready to give the reply. Only this was a skull, nothing was there. So how to test it? Then that mad person began to laugh and he told that all bogus persons, foolish, nonsense. I heard and I found it here, bogus. So I'm going, and he took his skull and was to go. In the meantime, Kalidas came. King prayed that madman, oh, wait a little. My one of the council is coming, and he may answer your question. He put that skull on the desk again, and Kalidas came. Again, this question was done to Kalidas, and Kalidas took a very long
stick
of
coconut
made of
stick.
Coconut stick, you know,
for booming,
very fine,
used for booming,
and very long.
Coconut
by which
used to broom.
Used to broom.
Yes,
in broom. One stick he took. And he went to that skull and put in this ear. And it went this side. Then he told, your question is answered. You understand?
No.
Oh, you should clear it. Again, king told that I am not understanding. He told that if anything comes here and goes here, that person is surely a foolish person. And if it was not to come out here and to go here, then it was surely a very intelligent person. So this skull of that person, originally he was very foolish. So hearing all things, but not taking here to cultivate all these teachings, are like foolish persons. They cannot flourish, they cannot develop their Krishna prema. So what? You have come from so many distant
places.
Very, very far away you have come. Don't take these teachings here and then take here. You should come here. Only to follow this. We have not any of us have not come to gain any worldly thing. We have come here that how we can develop our Krishna consciousness, Krishna bhakti. Generally we are of Kanishta Adhikari. It may be rare some of us be Madhyam Adhikari, not Uttam Adhikari in any case. So we are either in Kanishta Adhikari, some of us, you may be Madhyam Adhikari. So we should try to develop by hearing the instructions of Srila Rupa Goswami, explained by Srila Swamiji. When I am telling Swamiji or Bhaktivedanta Swamiji Maharaj, then you should understand that I am telling of my Siksha Gurus, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and your Prabhupada. So, don't think that Swamiji Maharaj is not in line of Rupa Goswami. And what Rupa Goswami has told, he is not telling the same words and same thing. Because he has told so many words. Rupa Goswami has told in two lines, in one slok. And Swamiji has explained in 10 pages. So he is not telling other thing. Only he is illuminating the same thing for those he is helping who are not understanding. So take in the same line. And also I am reading and I will explain Swamiji explanation. So don't think that he is telling other things, because his words are not same as Swamiji. Swamiji is not actually telling the same word that Rupa Goswami has told, but the meaning and purpose and the eternal motive is the same. So I am bringing from Krishna iti jasya giring tang manasadriyeta dikshasti cheta pranat bhishya bhajantamisham sutrusya bhajana vigyamananyamanya nindadi sunya siddhimepsati sangam. Fourth slok was relation with Vaishnavas. How to serve, how to associate Vaishnava. By six activities. Dadati pratigrahnati. Guhyam akhyati prichyati bhungte bhojyate chayuva sadavidham pratilakshanam he has told. I have explained this. So I am now coming to this. Krishna iti jasya ghari tan manasad. You should read the translation. You have no?
One should mentally honor the devotee who chants the holy name of Lord Krishna. One should offer humble obeisances to the devotee who has undergone spiritual initiation and is engaged in worshiping the deity. And one should associate with and faithfully serve that pure devotee who is advanced in undeviated devotional service and whose heart is completely devoid of the propensity to criticize others.
In this translation, or even in the text, has Swamiji mentioned anywhere that the devotee should be initiated by me myself? Has he told that we should deal with the devotees only initiated by me? Has he told?
No.
Either he has told that disciples my disciples, and their disciples only. We should think that only the disciples of my disciples are bona fide Vaishnava. But in whole world, none are Vaishnava. He has told. There is any particular demarcation line for this? So we should not think that he is only telling that my disciples in their what? Circumference.
Society.
Only their society. In Vaishnava society. Even in Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, even he may be of Sri Sampradaya, Ramanu Sampradaya, anyone, any of the Sampradaya, even a person out of any Sampradaya, four Sampradaya, Vaishnava Sampradaya, he has heard anything about Krishna glory, the glory of Krishna name. He has not taken initiation or name even, and he is uttering Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Swamiji has given example of his friend. He was not in the Krishna conscious society. He was not even initiated by anyone, first or second or anything initiation. He was a famous English musician. Musician. He has not left his all bad things, eating, drinking,
smoking,
and famous in song here and there. But he has some photos of Krishna in his house, respecting, and in his famous songs. He used to tell Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. Swamiji is telling in his explanation, anywhere I don't remember. Where?
Also here.
Yes. In this? But he is telling that we should think in the family of our family.
Yes.
And he should be respected. Whether he is drinking, he has intoxication, yes, or anything. And if he is initiated by anyone of Vaishnava or in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu family, we should must respect. If he is coming, don't criticize. If he is telling money. So here he is telling, Krishna iti jasya girin. Yes, you should read the purport.
About the meat eaters. I'll read the part
read
that you
section.
Just spoke about.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
We can see from practical experience that there are different types of Vaishnavas. The Prakriti Sahajiyas generally chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, yet they are attached to women, money, and intoxication.
You should know the paribhasha,
definition
of sahajiya. There are some of devotees are telling that Narayan Maharaj is pakka sahajiya. But you should hear the definition of sahajiya. What is the one?
They chant Hare Krishna, but they are attached to women, money, and intoxication.
What thing? First,
women, money, and intoxication.
Women,
money, and intoxication.
Well. But you should think, women here, men and women both each other. Don't think that only women. For men, women for
men.
Otherwise, it will be ex-party. And it will be offense for women ladies, devotees.
Although such persons may chant the holy name
wait
of the
a little.
Lord.
Wait a little.
She becomes enthusiastic.
That that they think that I'm involved in omens. Anyone can tell? I drink and smoke. Are any of the all bad things? I change my sannyasi dress when I come to my home, mandir, and I change the clothes when I go to Western other countries.
Even at, not Singapore also.
Never. And about money, I don't want money. I want pure hearts, only to help them. Then who are sahajiyas? Those who are telling are myself. You can understand who are the sahajiyas. Those who are telling, not following all these things, also they are sahajiya. All that. So Krishna has given intelligence to think all these things. Don't believe, blunder, what?
Blindly. Without thinking.
Don't think. Don't believe on merely
words,
rumor. Propaganda.
Rumors.
Yes, rumors.
Don't. Today in Kali Yuga, only propaganda and rumors are most
prominent
weapons. But Vaishnava does not apply all these things. This would be out of these things. Then again?
Although such persons may chant the holy name of the Lord, they are not yet properly purified. Such people should be respected within one's mind, but their association should be avoided. Those who are innocent, but simply carried away by bad association, should be shown favor if they are eager to receive proper instructions from pure devotees. That's for the...
Now come to the purport. We will try to properly be established what Swamiji is telling. My English is not perfect, but you should take this sense. You should read in order to perfect.
In order to intelligently apply the sixfold loving reciprocations mentioned in the previous verse, one must select proper persons with careful discrimination. Srila Rupa Goswami therefore advises...
If any question, you can ask. This is East Goshti, not a very
lecture
or anything. I will not be disturbed.
Srila Rupa Goswami therefore advises that we should meet with Vaishnavas in an appropriate way according to their particular status.
What is the paribhasa? Definition of Vaishnava? He has told here Vaishnava word. What is the
definition
of Vaishnava? Who has taken Vishnu mantra, Krishna mantra, Ram mantra, and worshipping that deities by same mantra, following the rules and regulations. There are all Vaishnava. He is my disciple, so he is Vaishnava, and all are not Vaishnava. This is offense. We should not make offenses like this. Anyone without caste and creed, we should adopt all this paribhasa, Vaishnava. Anyone who is chanting, one is initiated in Vaishnava mantra and worshipping deities in that mantra, following the rules, all are Vaishnava. The worshipper of Ram, the worshipper of Nrisimha, worshipper of Krishna, worshipper of Vishnu, in proper way, but not like Mayabadi. Mayabadi also chant Krishna name, but they are not in proper Vaishnava way. So he is telling Vaishnava. Then,
in this verse, he tells how to deal with three types of devotees.
Mm.
The Kanistha Adhikari, Madhyama Adhikari, and Uttama Adhikari.
Mm.
The Kanistha Adhikari is a neophyte who has received the Harinam initiation from the spiritual master and is trying to chant the holy name of Krishna.
One, you should think, a man has taken Harinam. What is the need of taking Diksha? Can you, anyone reply? You?
You, yourself?
Yes, you. Oh, what name? Stand up. Very soon.
Raghunath Bhatta.
I don't remember the name.
Raghunath Bhatta.
Then you should sit. You should tell.
In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Prabhupada says to bring one closer to the spiritual master.
I could not understand.
In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Swami Maharaj says that to bring the disciple closer to Krishna, Diksha mantras are given.
What is the difference? I want to know. Between Harinam and Diksha, what is prominent, name or Diksha?
Stated Nama Chintamani Krishna's Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. Punashirani Chamukta Abhinapam Nama Namino.
You should hear properly, and if you want, you can question. Mm-hmm. No harm.
That name is not different from Nami, name of Krishna and Krishna himself, that they're not different. So, it's stated, by chanting the holy name, Hare Krishna, then one can achieve Krishna prema. But Diksha, taking Diksha initiation, Gayatri, then that can take one to liberation, but Nam can give Krishna prema. So, of the two, even though there's more restriction on Diksha, but actually Harinam is more prominent.
Anyone more can clear?
There may be some.
You can stand up.
Guru Maharaj, with all due respect, we heard yesterday in the introduction of your Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindu that in the life story of Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he was visited by Srimati Swamini Radharani herself to explain that the Kam Gayatri Mantra was so important for the revelation of Braj itself and for the devotee to actually have the full realization of the devata of this mantra. So, from my understanding from your good self, I believe that Diksha is more important than Harinam.
You?
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he explains that...
very important thing. It is not a very general or common thing.
He explains that actually Harinam is sufficient. However, is sufficient for bringing the jivatma back to Krishna, but in our conditioned state, we have so many impurities and contaminations and anarthas. So especially, the Gayatri Mantra is very helpful for purification to help us go
forward.
What
do you mean by Gayatri Mantra?
Brahma Gayatri.
All the ladies devotees have no Brahma Gayatri, then how to
all the Gayatri.
Oh, they are hopeless. You are hopeless.
Brahma Gayatri and Guru Gayatri and Mahaprabhu Gayatri and Kam Gayatri and Gopal Gayatri.
Gopal Gayatri, where?
Gopal Mantra. Gopal Mantra.
Where is Gopal Gayatri? I have never heard. Anything more? You can tell. Very mildly you should hear.
Dikha kale guru...
Khub beshi kare explain.
When guru gives diksha, then he make his disciple like his own level. And dikha means dibba gyanam jato daddat kurjat papasya sanchayam tasmat dikshati praktadeshikai tattakavidoi. Who is tattavid? That's all. Diksha means guru gives dibba gyan and divine knowledge, dibba gyan, and kurjat papasya sanchayam, and he destroy and burn his all kind of sin. If we take Harinam as before, here there is some sin, but Guru by Diksha Mantra burned all things. Somebody says that, oh, Gurudev takes all sin from Sishya, so Gurudev used to suffer. It is not correct.
If common point, actual point.
So Diksha Mantra will take us up the gate of Vaikuntha. Not beyond Vaikuntha.
No, this is not my question. What is the difference between Harinam and Diksha?
Diksha will take up the gate of Vaikuntha and Diksha Mantra will give us relationship. And Holy Name take us to Braj. Just like Gop Kumar, he received Gopal Mantra from his Gurudev and he went before up to Vaikuntha, but when he get Nam, then he went beyond Vaikuntha. Harinam is prominent, but Diksha matured the Harinam.
But I went to cook. I was cooking. Fire was there, on a chulla.
Stove.
Stove was there. Pot was there. Fire was there, water was there, everything was there, but not rice. Cooking will be done or not?
No.
So take this Nam as the rice. But without the help of chulla,
stove,
water, fire, pot, it cannot be boiled. But if all things are there but not rice there, no use. But if there is rice, everything is right. When we will have all these things, then we can boil it and we'll take. Understand? Understand by example? Now you can hear more. Name is himself Krishna and Radha, or Krishna, you should think. This is like rice. And fire and all other things,
Diksha Mantra.
To make it realized and to make it to realize that name is himself Krishna, all are required. To purify myself, not to purify Krishna name. Krishna name is always Namah Chintamani, Krishna Rasa Chaitanya Vigraha, Purna Shuddha, Nitya Mukta, Abhinatvatana. Krishna is same as his name. No difference. Name kabhan cannot be impure. Always pure. Always chinmay, sachidanandamay. But according to our stage, we cannot take it as pure name, or we can take pure name. Understand? If we are full of ignorance, full of all kind of worldly desires, full of unearths, so many kinds, and full of offenses, then what we will utter Krishna name will not be Krishna name. At that time you are standing on the platform of Maya, avidya. So that name will not be pure. So to give its very test in taking name, to purify our heart, to have link a relationship between Krishna and myself, this name and myself, and to give up away all kinds of anartha, avidya, diksha is needed. As fire is needed to boil water, but only boiling water will not do, there some rice should be there. So, diksha is given to purify our heart and have a link with Krishna, so that very soon we can realize that Krishna is Himself, name is Himself Krishna. So, now you understand, diksha is to help the relationship between Krishna and that devotee, that Gopi Janna Ballabhaya Swaha. Swaha means, I am offering myself, I am dedicating myself fully in the lotus feet of Krishna. Which Krishna? Name Krishna, name Brahma. With what relation? That the same relation with gopis to Gopi Jana Ballabha. By this relationship we should take if name, giving up all diksha, the Dibyam Gyanam Dadati, gives Dibya Gyan. What? This relationship. This is Dibya relationship, that Krishna is my beloved. Whether he is male or female devotee, no harm. So this relation, with this relation, diksha gives this relation. If you are not taking diksha, this relationship will not be there. And you will not be able to give up all your worldly desires and all the bad things. So it adds and helps. But we said that if anyone has not taken initiation means diksha here, only name, like Haridas Thakur has no initiation. There are so many examples for this. No initiation, but yet chanting and being the association of very realized devotees, they have received the Krishna prem. But it is rare. So we should come to rules and regulations in this way. So we must take diksha. If you are thinking that I am like Haridas Thakur, then nothing will come. So now I think that you have properly realized this thing. What is the difference between name and diksha? Only diksha is there, but he is not taking name. What will be? If you are taking, not taking name, but only diksha mantra, take out the Krishna name from that Gopal mantra. Swaha, swaha.
No rice.
Nothing?
Liberation so, like
that. No liberation.
Nothing. Hot water.
If Krishna is taken from that mantra, what remains? Nothing, zero. Yeah. So, name has two functions. With some swaha, namaskar, namah, kling, sring, all these things mixing. Vij mantra, and there are some swaha, namaskar. It gives some special kind of power to give up all these bad things. Without that you cannot. Name can also do, but why you should use it? You should not use for this thing. Very little things can do these things. Why? So, name only can do everything, but it will take very long process. But by this, our rishis, our devotees has invented. So quickly, how we can develop our Krishna name into Shuddha, pure name? And that is why Diksha is given. In our disciplic order, Diksha is given. Now go on. He has given. I'm not telling other than Swamiji. Or if you are telling that, you are not telling the same word. That if I'm telling same word, we cannot understand. What are the modes behind Swamiji? Hard for explaining.
A Madhyama Adhikari has received spiritual initiation from the spiritual master and has been fully engaged by him in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. The Madhyama Adhikari should be considered to be situated midway in devotional service. The Uttama Adhikari, or highest devotee, is one who is very advanced in devotional service.
Okay.
He is not interested in blaspheming others. His heart is completely...
And Uttama Adhikari is not interested in...
blaspheming others.
Means?
Ninda.
That is bluffing. Yes.
His heart is completely clean, and he has attained the realized state of unalloyed Krishna consciousness. According to Rupa Goswami, the association and service of such a Mahabhagavata or perfect Vaishnava are most desirable.
He should, again I'm telling, he should be the disciple of the same guru or any guru. He's not telling that among my disciples only. Never he will write like this. In any books, in Chaitanya Charitamrita also, in Upanishad, in Srimad Bhagavatam, who has initiated Parikshit Maharaj? Who was the guru of Parikshit Maharaj? He has not initiated him.
Krishna.
But Parikshit Maharaj is telling that he is my Gurudev. And he is associating with him and hearing Harikatha from him. So you should think like this. If I am not initiated by only by my Gurudev, and he will not be Vaishnava, mood is
offensive.
Anywhere in Sat Sampradaya, especially in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, he is coming. And he is qualified, and he is Vaishnava, even Madhyam Adhikari. He should be honored, and he should be heard. Go on.
One should not remain...
Very carefully this line.
One should not remain a Kanistha Adhikari.
I'm always telling this. Some are telling that you should always be book distributing, always. And making money, whole life. And this will take you to Golok Vrindavan in the service of Gopi Prem. Quite absurd. Those who are telling, I'm thinking they're foolish. Swamiji is not telling this. That is Yashukriti, it must be done. For newcomers, new fight, they must do all these things, what Swamiji has told. But they should know. Only this book distribution will not do. They should go deep in his purpose. Then it will be done. A man only distributing lakhs and lakhs births, he will do coming and going in birth and death. He will have some Sukriti. Swamiji had not told that one should remain always in a kya? Kanishtha Adhikari. He had not told. He had told that one should not remain a Kanishtha Adhikari for always. But we are insisting that we should be like that. And this is the highest topic of service. It is like bluffing them. Quite bluffing them. We should not bluff anyone. Why they are then falling? They are blushing persons for their own gain. 25% giving and 75 pick coming in your pocket. Swamiji is saying everything. He cannot tolerate. So we should be, one should not remain in a Kanishtha Adhikari, he should try by hearing. Greed will come if he is hearing a bona fide Vaishnava. If he is cultivating and obeying the orders of Vaishnavas, Swamiji, he must be in Madhyam Adhikari. And Madhyam Adhikari will go to Uttam Adhikari. And Uttam Adhikari will go to Krishna Prem. In Vastu Siddhi, we have not come to always being in a same Kanishtha Adhikari and offending, making offenses. We have not come. Anyone willn't be satisfied by always being a Kanishtha Adhikari. Now, then one who is Suvachachad on the lowest.
One should not remain a Kanishtha Adhikari.
You should all try to become Madhyam Adhikari. And those who are in Madhyam Adhikari, they should come in Madhyam Madhyam. And those who are in Madhyam Madhyam, they should come in Madhyam Uttam. And those who are in Uttam, they should try to realize Sarup Siddhi. And after Sarup Siddhi, Vastu. Swamiji has written everything. Everything. Shravandasa, Varandasa, Smaranadasa, then Bhavapandasa, Sampattidasa. All he has written. But we have no chance to go through these books, only to give books. And this will do take us to that higher.
So, if one is hearing from Rasik Vaishnava,
Rasik Vaishnava or Tattvajna Vaishnava, Madhyam Adhikari,
advancing from Kanishtha to Madhyam stage, then if that person is still distributing books, is that supreme?
No harm, no harm. It is then, at that time, it is bhakti. This thing to distribute books is bhakti.
But it's a level of consciousness of the person who's
distributing. Yes, anything. A man is brooming. It is not in among 64 kinds of bhakti. But it will be the highest topic of brooming in the kunj. So everything. What we should not do, or we are doing, sometimes nonsense also, for worldly persons, it becomes highest service of Krishna. But it depends on that stage. So we must try to go in Madhyam Adhikari, and Madhyam Adhikari should try to go in Uttam Adhikari. So Swami Maharaj is not telling that one should not remain a Kanishtha Adhikari forever. He should. But he should try to. If he is not trying, then we should think that he is association is not good. There is some lackness, leakage on that. Either in his guru, either his himself. His guru is not prominent. So try to give up that guru. If our eagerness is not coming, our enthusiasm is not coming, and we are not trying to develop our Krishna consciousness from Kanishtha Adhikari to Madhyama, that guru should be given up. No? Then,
So one should not remain a Kanistha Adhikari, or one who is situated on the lowest platform of devotional service and is interested only in worshipping the deity.
Only worshipping, 1,000 years. But not serving any high class of Vaishnava. It will not do. If you want to develop, you can do worship, but at time also you will have to develop your Krishna consciousness by association of Uttam Rasik Vaishnava. Otherwise, what?
Gurudev, I was wondering what is the minimum qualification of a...
You should hear all these things, and gradually your all question will be solved. But hear very patiently and very deeply.
Such a devotee...
Try to don't take your mind on other subject. What here we are dealing, we should try to observe one thing only. Don't go out of line. Only the thing I am giving here. What Swamiji is telling. Try to understand that word, the deep meaning of the sentence and his mood. Then you can develop.
A person who is faithfully engaged in the worship of the deity in the temple, but who does not know how to behave towards devotees or people in general, is called a Prakriti Bhakta or Kanistha Adhikari.
You should know what is Kanistha Adhikari. And then take your hand here and judge yourself that in what Adhikari you are, what stage you are. You can easily think that in what Adhikari we are. Otherwise you cannot. And then try to develop it. Who is Kanistha Adhikari?
Does not know.
Who? Oh, yes?
No.
I want to have a definition of his.
He worships the deity, but he does not know how to receive the Vaishnava.
He has no association of any good Vaishnava, and only worshipping. And thinking himself that I am more than him.
Right.
If he wants to give anyone coming and giving so much money, then he will take that. If I am not honoring him, then he may go and he will not give money. So I should honor him. So he will take the garland of Thakurji and give how? Like this. He will not touch, he will throw it. Like you will go to Bihariji Mandir, any mandir of
Vrindavan.
All Goswamis who are Kanishta Adhikari, they will only throw to devotees who are Uttam Mahabhagavat. If Sukhdev Goswami will come, Narad will come, they will throw like this. Because they don't know anything. They think that, oh, that deity is not mine. So this deity can be dishonored. But this is my Thakur. And this is only thing to be honored, not all others. Why they are giving donation to that deity? They should all give to my deity. He is not thinking that my deity is everywhere. My deity is full Krishna. They cannot think. Because they have not developed their Krishna consciousness. You should try to develop in such a way. I think that it is now 12. Now, Gaur Pramanande. I think this will be interesting for you.
Yes.
Also to realize Swamiji teachings. I'm not telling anything, but I'm telling the words of Swamiji here. Don't think that I'm telling anything, separate things are here and there. But
one thing I remember, your explanation on Diksha, there's one purport where Srila Prabhupada, he explains, just like you have explained about Gaya.
Yes.
Exactly like that.
Where?
In Chaitanya Charitamrita.
Anywhere you will see in any authentic book, you will see my this. So you should try to hear, because I think that you have not so much opportunity to be with Swamiji. And sat practically with direct relations. I have that occasion. I am lucky to serve him so more than 50, 60 years. So you can hear something and you can develop your faith. Gaur Praman.
Shrila Gurudev Ki
Jai.
I'm not Gurudev.
Yes.
I'm devotee. Very. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare
Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Uta lo, niya ja.
Rama, Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna.